So here the industrial manufacture of beer number one, steep barley is fermented, and after the proper fermentation, the process of germination is stopped by drying. So once the steep or the barley is fully fermented, and after fermentation, it is dry. As a result, we will get the kiln malt, because in that drying process, we will get this malt, that is called kiln malt, is obtained. And during the process of malting, this process is called malting. The diastase is a type of enzyme, and this diastase enzyme is produced, and this is converting the complex starch into maltose, means which contains two glucose molecule, but it's very little amount is converted, not fully, because of the kiln malt after drying. A small amount of starch into maltose. If it is converted more into maltose, then there will be some loss of product. Number two, formation of what? That is gelatinous mass, gummy mass, mixing with maize and with this malt, that is kiln malt. That process is called wort processing. And after wort processing, then we will go for fermentation. These steps are there in the industrial manufacture of beer. So in this process, that is called formation of wort, the raw grain of maize is first gelatinized. It is converted into form of gelatin, semi-solid mass. With this process, that is called with high pressure and steam. Steam and high pressure is passed, so whole the maize starch is converted into gelatinous mass, and that is called gelatinization. And then mixed with malt. After once it, gelatin is formed, then that kiln malt is mixed. Grist is mixed. That is called malt grist. And it is then turned into, that is called malt. So malt is actually the mixture of malt grit, gelatinous mass of maize, and plus some amount of water, that is at about 75 degree centigrade, it is kept with water. After mashing, this process is called mashing. After mashing, the wort is washed, and then with hot water, and the entire mass is separated from the spent grains. Their wort is cooked and mixed with flower of hop. Hop is a cannabis plant, and that flower is widely used to develop the flavor and taste of the beer. That is called hop. And the beer, which is having peculiar bitter flavor and taste, is because of the presence of the resins and tannins from the flower of the hop. To get the extract of aroma, tannins, 10 to 15 pound hops are sufficient in 1000 gallon of, that is worts, and boiling will take place at least for 3 hours. So now the gelatinous mass is transferred to fermentation unit or plant, where there are big chambers. One chamber is called upper chamber, second one is called middle, and third one is called lower chamber. And in lower chamber there is yeast, and this yeast is mixed with those that work, and the process will take in the beginning for 7 to 8 hours, then 2-3 days, and complete fermentation will be done in 7 to 8 days. And after that, when beer is formed and that beer is separated out from yeast, and that one is bottle, which contains 4 to 6% ethyl alcohol, and this separated yeast is also sold as an edible yeast, little bit cheaper, because some people they like that yeast which is mixed with hop flower aroma, that gives very good flavor and bitter taste. Number three, fermentation of wort. The cool wort is then transferred to a fermentation plant, which consists of three chambers. One is upper chamber, second one is middle chamber, and the third one is lower chamber. The chamber, we know the fermentation process is exothermic. Exothermic means where heat is involved, and heat may go up to more than 38 to 40 degree centigrade temperature, and that is not favorable for fermentation, because for fermentation the temperature should not exceed more than 35 degree centigrade. So we have to attach some cooling tower or some cooling condensers, so that temperature is maintained up to between 30 to 35 degree centigrade temperature, so that maximum fermentation will take place. Is important 35 degree centigrade temperature to be maintained. The upper and middle chambers are fermentation chambers. See, upper and middle, where the fermentation will take place, and they are known as fermentation chamber, and the lower chamber is known as yeast chamber, where yeast is there. And number four, first a small amount of wort is mixed with yeast in vessel, and this will allow to ferment and grow the yeast. So the seedling will be prepared with the help of yeast to ferment and to grow. The yeast is then transferred, this mixture is then transferred to upper chamber, and where the fermentation will take place, and the whole wort is allowed to ferment at least for 3 days in upper chamber, and in whole wort is in middle chamber is transferred, and the beer which collects in the yeast chamber with yeast is separated from the yeast by pressing, and this fermentation in a middle chamber is allowed for 7 to 8 days, and after that the yeast and beer is separated, and then the end of the process is the beer is drawn off in the bottles, and the beer contains 4 to 6% ethyl alcohol, and the separated yeast is sold as edible yeast. So with this I will stop, and with this the chapter of alcoholic beverages, the industries which are based on fermentation, is over. Once again, thank you very much for watching the lecture.